नमस्कार, आप सभी का स्वागत है। मैं हूं राहुल और आप देख रहे हैं पीएम ई विद्या चैनल्स और एनसीईआरटी का ऑफिशियल यूट्यूब चैनल। हम लेकर हाजिर हैं अपना आज का अगला लाइव इंटरेक्टिव सेशन लेकर, जो है मैथमेटिक्स का क्लास है 10th, और हम पढ़ने जा रहे हैं मैथमेटिक्स में पॉलिनोमियल्स एंड दिस इज द पार्ट 3। यू हैव ऑलरेडी वॉच्ड पार्ट 1 एंड 2 एंड आई एम श्योर आपने जो भी सीखा होगा वो आपको याद होगा, बट हम उसका एक थोड़ा सा रिकैप भी करेंगे एंड देन विल स्टार्ट पार्ट 3। आई होप आज हमारा पॉलिनोमियल्स फिनिश हो जाएगा, खत्म हो जाएगा। तो आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट आवर गेस्ट मिस सविता ग्राहक फ्रॉम कुरुक्षेत्र। सविता जी, गुड आफ्टरनून एंड अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम इन द सेशन।
गुड आफ्टरनून एंड नमस्कार टू ऑल आवर व्यूअर्स, टू राहुल जी यूट्यूब।
बिल्कुल, और सो आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू प्लीज स्टार्ट पॉलिनोमियल्स विद द ब्रीफ की पॉलिनोमियल्स होते क्या है एंड इफ यू हैव एनी रिकैप ऑफ पार्ट 1 एंड 2 सो दैट वी कैन गो अहेड फॉर पार्ट 3।
Okay, so for polynomials, first of all, we are discussing about what we have done in session 1 and 2 for this topic.
Mm-hmm.
Polynomials, algebraic expressions our students have studied and they are studying for the same from their class 6. Before this class, they have studied about the numbers only, whether these are natural numbers or whole numbers. But when they have entered to their class 6, they have to thought of a number jo unhe exactly nahi pata. For example, I have some money in my hand. Mm-hmm. I'm not telling ki kitna amount hai, whether it is 100 rupees or 500 rupees or 1000. So the students can guess, let there be X rupees.
Okay.
So such type of number which is unknown to us, which can vary. Any student can guess that there are 10 rupees. Any student can guess that there are 2000 rupees. Mm-hmm. So these numbers are known as variables. X or Y or Z. And when we are discussing about various types of polynomials, these are linear polynomial, quadratic polynomial, cubic polynomial, biquadratic polynomial, which has been categorized on the basis of the degrees of these all polynomials. Of course, if the degree is 1, for example, I am writing an expression 2x plus 3. So this 2x plus 3, in this expression, we can see that the degree of this variable x is 1. That is why it is a linear polynomial. Similarly, if we are writing an expression ax square plus bx plus c, where a is not equals to 0, that means the coefficient of x square is not equals to 0, then this polynomial is known as a quadratic polynomial. And if the degree of the polynomial is 3, then that is cubic polynomial. And if the degree is 4, that is biquadratic polynomial. After that, we have studied about zeros of a polynomial. Now, let us discuss it again. What is a zero of a polynomial? If I am writing x minus 3, This is a linear polynomial.
Okay.
So the value of x for which this complete polynomial becomes 0 will be known as the zero of the polynomial. Now, for what value of x will this expression become 0? This is x is equal to 3. If we put x equals to 3 here, then we are able to get that 3 minus 3 is 0. Therefore, x is equal to 3 will be known as the zero of this polynomial. Similarly, we can factorize a quadratic polynomial to find the zeros of that particular. We also know that if there is a quadratic polynomial, then there can be at most 2 zeros. If the polynomial is cubic, then there can be at most 3 zeros. Now, after that, we have also studied about the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients of a linear polynomial or a quadratic polynomial or a cubic polynomial. If we are writing a cubic polynomial, let it be ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, then these values a, b, c and d are known as the coefficients of this polynomial, and there is a relationship between the zeros and the coefficients of this particular polynomial about which we have studied earlier. And today we are going to find a polynomial. What we have done in our previous sessions, we have done that if a polynomial is given to us, then how can we find its zeros? But today we are discussing about if the sum of the zeros and the product of the zeros are given, then how can we find the quadratic polynomial? So here, the sum of the zeros and product of the zeros are given to us for a quadratic polynomial. Since it is a quadratic polynomial, therefore it will have two zeros. And let us suppose alpha and beta be the zeros of the first part given here. And if alpha and beta are the zeros of this polynomial, then we have been given that the sum of the zeros is 4. And what do we mean by the sum of zeros? That means alpha plus beta is given to be 4. And we know it very well that alpha plus beta equals to minus b upon a, where a and b are the coefficients of the given polynomial. Or we must say of the required polynomial. And what is alpha beta? That is the product of zeros. And product of zeros is c upon a, which is 1 over here. And we know that if the sum and product of zeros is given to us, then the required polynomial is, it will be x square minus sx plus p. That means x square minus sum of zeros into x plus product of zeros. That means S is presenting here the value of alpha plus beta, and P is presenting here the value of alpha into beta, the product. So simply in place of X, we need to put the value of alpha plus beta, and in place of P, we need to put the value of alpha beta. Therefore, the required polynomial will be X square minus 4X plus 1. Similarly, we will discuss one more part here for the same question. And in this second part, the statement is x square minus sx plus p. We know that the quadratic polynomial will be in the form x square minus sum of zeros plus product of zeros. So what is the sum of zeros here? It is root 2, and it will be known as the value of s. What is the product of zeros? That has been given to us in the form, in fractional form, minus 3 upon 2, and it is the value of p. So we have the required polynomial as x square minus the value of s root 2 into x plus product of zeros, which is minus 3 upon 2. If we take 2 as LCM, so we can rewrite the same polynomial as it is equivalent to 2x square minus 2 root 2x, and positive negative sign becomes negative. So the required polynomial is 2x square minus 2 root 2x minus 3. So in this way, we can find a quadratic polynomial if the relationship between the zeros and coefficients are given to us.
Okay.
Now we will discuss a question, and this time we need to find a cubic polynomial.
Okay.
And the relationship between its zeros and coefficients has been given to us. There are three relationships. The first is the sum of the zeros is given to be 2. Alpha plus beta is 2. I must write alpha plus beta plus gamma. Since it is a cubic polynomial, so it will have three zeros, alpha, beta and gamma at the most. These zeros can be same, two of them can be same, and all three can be distinct. So alpha plus beta plus gamma equals to 2. After this, we have been given that the sum of product of its two zeros taken at a time. If we take two zeros at a time, alpha into beta and their product, beta gamma, gamma alpha. And the sum of all of these three products is negative 7. And the last relationship is the product of its zeros is given to be minus 14. That means product of the zeros, alpha into beta into gamma, it is minus 14. So what will be the required cubic polynomial? The required cubic polynomial will be x cube minus sx square. So before I'm telling that this will be the required, let us discuss about how can we rewrite alpha plus beta plus gamma as it can be written as s, the sum of all the three zeros, and we are writing s and its base is p, that means sum of product of two zeros taken at a time. And alpha into beta plus gamma, it is taken as p, p means product. So we have the cubic polynomial as x cube minus sx square plus sp into x minus p means product. So the sign for x cube will be positive, then negative, again positive, and then for the constant polynomial it is a negative sign here. And the sum of the zeros will be taken along with x square, as we know that alpha plus beta plus gamma equals to minus b upon a, where b is presenting us the coefficient of x square and a is the coefficient of x cube. So we will put all the values which are there with us here. And what are these values? These values are s is 2. So the polynomial is x cube minus 2x square minus 7 into x, because the value of sp is given to be minus 7, and then minus p.
14.
The value of the p is minus 14. So finally our answer is x cube minus 2x square minus 7x plus 14. In this way we can find a cubic polynomial.
Okay.
And now we are discussing one more question. And in this question again, our stress will be on the relationship between the zeros and coefficients of a cubic polynomial. Now let us first write down that if our cubic polynomial is compared with ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, where a is not equals to 0. The given cubic polynomial here is x cube minus 3x square plus x plus 1. So we have to take care of it that here we are taking capital A, capital B, not small. What is the reason behind that? Because small a and small b has been used here already in the question.
Yes.
So if we will take the coefficients also in the smaller units, then we will get confused. That's why we have taken these as capital A, B, C and D. So on comparing, what are we obtaining? We are obtaining that the value of A is 1. Nothing has been written along with x cube. Therefore, we will consider it as 1. Now, what is the value of B? The coefficient of x square, which is of course minus 3. The value of C, it is 1. And D is again 1. He is saying that the three zeros are A minus B, A and A plus B. And we know that we treat zeros as alpha, beta and gamma. So directly we have been given that the value of alpha is A minus B, the value of beta is A and the value of gamma is A plus B. So what does we have? We have the relationship alpha plus beta plus gamma equals to minus B upon A. This we have studied in our session 2. And now we just have to put all the values which are there with us. In place of alpha, we will put the value A minus B. In place of beta, we will put A. And in place of gamma, we will put A plus B. It is equals to minus B. The value of B here is minus 3 divided by A. So we are able to get that B can be cancelled, and then 3a equals to 3 and then a is equal to 1. So in this way, by using the relationship, we are able to get one of the values out of a and b. This is a. Now we will calculate the value of b. And how will be that possible? Calculate this value. Let us see one more relationship for this cubic polynomial. We know that there are total three relationships. Out of this, one has been used. Now let us use alpha into beta into gamma, the product of all the three zeros. And what it is? It is minus d upon a.
Okay.
So we have put the value of d and a here. The value of d is 1 and the value of a is also 1. So here one identity can be used. What is a minus b into a plus b? It is undoubtedly a square minus b square. But before putting that identity, we can put the value of a, which we have just calculated. It is 1. And on solving it, we are able to get 1 1 minus b into 1 plus b, which is 1 minus b square equals to minus 1. On solving it, we are able to find the value of b, which is positive or negative root 2. So as a result, we have a is 1 and b can be positive root 2 or it can also be negative root 2, because b square is equal to 2. And if b square is 2, then b can hold two values. It can be positive or negative root 2. Now, after discussing this relationship, let us move to the next question. And this is based on division algorithm. What is division algorithm? You people have studied about it in your class 9 very much clearly, that how can we divide a polynomial by another polynomial. Okay. So today we are discussing the same, but we have to think that by what polynomial we have to divide the given polynomial. The question is, find all the zeros of the given polynomial. Now, dear students, see what is the degree of this polynomial. It is clearly 4. So there can be total 4 zeros at the most for this particular polynomial. And out of those 4 zeros, we have been given 2 zeros. And these 2 zeros are 2 plus root 3 and the other 0 is 2 minus root 3. The first 0 is, let us consider it as alpha, 2 minus root 3, and the second 0 is 2 plus root 3. It doesn't matter where we are taking positive or where we are taking negative sign. So two zeros are there with us. Now let us learn about it, or let us think about it again, that if this is a polynomial, quadratic polynomial, and I say that x equals to 1 is its zero. That means when we will put x is equal to 1, this complete polynomial will be zero. 1 minus 3 plus 2. Yes. So, in that case, what can we say about x minus 1? Agar hum 1 ko left side par drag karte hain, to x minus 1 will be known as a factor of the given polynomial. So, same here we can see, if I say that x is equal to 2 plus root 3 and x equals to 2 minus root 3, these are the two zeros. And because of these two, what can we say? We can say that x minus 2 minus root 3 and x minus 2 plus root 3. These two are the factors of given polynomial. Okay?
Okay.
And if these two are the factors of given polynomial, let us take a very simple example for it. If we have a number 60, and we know 2 is a factor of 60. 2 ke table par 60 completely divide ho jata hai. Uh-huh. 3 is also a factor of 60. So what can we say about 2 times 3? 2 threes are 6. Kya 6 bhi 60 ka ek factor hai? Kya 6 ke table par bhi 60 completely divide ho raha hai? So your answer will be yes. Similarly, agar aapke paas ye first is a factor of the given polynomial, this is also a factor, then their product will also be a factor of the given polynomial. That means their product will be what? It will be x minus 2 minus root 3 into x minus 2 plus root 3 is also a factor of given polynomial. Agar hum given polynomial ko p of x or f of x something assume kar lete hain, then we can write it in short here of px. Now let us try to multiply both of these polynomials. This can be think upon as a minus b into a plus b, or we can say a square minus b square is also a factor. So we have x square minus 4x plus 1 is also a factor of given polynomial. So हमने किया क्या है, हमने पहले discuss किया given zeros की help से two factors, and then we can also write if this and this both are the factors, then their product will also be a factor of the given polynomial. So agar ye product given polynomial ka factor hai, so it simply meant that agar hum put karte hain, divide karte hain apne polynomial se, that means x square minus 4x plus 1 se given polynomial ko. So what can we get? Let us see what was the given polynomial. It is 2 into x raised to the power 4 माइनस नाइन एक्स क्यूब प्लस 5x² + 3x - 1. तो नाउ सिंपली डिवीजन एल्गोरिथम का यूज करते हुए वी विल डिवाइड दिस कंप्लीटली. दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. एज
आई थिंक सविता जी का इशारा इसी ओर था कि दिस इज द क्वेश्चन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एज वी आर इन क्लास 10th. और जब ऐसा कुछ होता है तो टीचर जो सॉल्व कर रहे होते हैं मैथमेटिक्स की बुक्स में, मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम वी गेट सेम क्वेश्चंस इन आर बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशंस. आपको सिर्फ तरीका उसका आना चाहिए, आपको वो क्वेश्चंस समझ में आने चाहिए, आपके कंसेप्ट्स क्लियर होने चाहिए ताकि आप उस टाइप के क्वेश्चंस को ईजिली सॉल्व कर सकें. क्योंकि मैथमेटिक्स में जो टाइम का मैनेजमेंट है वो बहुत ज़रूरी है, और किसी भी एग्जाम में जब आप अपीयर होते हैं तो टाइम मैनेजमेंट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. हमारा सेशन हम अभी लेकर हाजिर होंगे. एक छोटे से ब्रेक के लिए यहाँ रुकते हैं, आप जुड़े रहिए पीएम ई विद्या चैनल्स के साथ. ब्रेक के बाद हम फिर हाजिर हैं और हम जल्दी से वहीं से शुरू करेंगे जहाँ से हमारी बातचीत रह गई थी. कॉम्प्लेक्स एक क्वेश्चन तरीके का जो हमारा पॉलिनोमियल्स का था वो हम सॉल्व कर रहे थे. सविता जी मैं आपसे गुजारिश करूंगा, वुड यू प्लीज कंटिन्यू.
यस बिल्कुल. तो हम डिवाइड कर रहे थे बाय दिस क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलिनोमियल आर गिवन बाय क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलिनोमियल एंड वी वर हियर दैट माइनस एक्स क्यूब प्लस 3x² + 3x - 1. सो द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन विल बी नेगेटिव ऑफ x, क्योंकि हमें सोचना होता है कि x स्क्वायर को किस से मल्टीप्लाई करें दैट वी आर एबल टू गेट नेगेटिव एक्स क्यूब एंड दैट विल बी ऑफ कोर्स माइनस x. And on multiplication, we are getting negative x cube, positive 4x² and negative x. Again, on solving it, we are able to get negative x square, positive 4x and negative 1. So now, by what a number should x square be multiplied to get negative x square? It is negative 1. And on multiplication, we are able to get negative x square, positive 4x, negative 1. That means we can clearly see that the remainder will here be 0. So if we haven't done any mistake, kyunki hame pata hai that the divisor x square minus 4x plus 1 is a factor of the given polynomial. Therefore, for sure our remainder must be 0.
Okay.
Otherwise, we might have done any mistake agar hamare paas remainder 0 nahi aata. So on getting this we can see two more the combination of two more factors of the given polynomial and we can rewrite the polynomial p of x as hame pata hai ki koi bhi polynomial ko hum likh sakte hain dividend equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. The divisor is the combination of the given two zeros and the quotient is the combination of the two zeros which we have to calculate. Of course, we will not solve the first part, but we will factorize the second part.
Okay.
We will split the middle term, and on splitting it, we are able to get 2x plus 1 into x minus 1. And by equating both of these factors to zeros, we are able to get two more zeros of the given polynomial, and these two more zeros are negative 1 upon 2 if we equate this particular polynomial to be 0, and if we equate this to be 0 then we are able to get the other 0 to be 1. So there are total 4 zeros of this biquadratic polynomial. 2 were given to us, 2 plus root 3 and 2 minus root 3, and 2 are here which we have calculated, negative 1 by 2 and positive 1. So see the question again carefully. It is find all the zeros. Dear viewers, whenever all the zeros have been demanded, so it is a must to write in answer all four zeros. Most of the time, kya hota hai, students bhool jate hain ye do zeros answer mein mention karna, which are already given to us. Aur hum yehi do zeros answer mein mention kar de.
Right. तो यानी कि जो सबसे ज्यादा जरूरी है वो carefully पढ़ना जरूरी है. आपका जो क्वेश्चन है वो केयरफुली पढ़ना बहुत जरूरी है ताकि गलती ना होने पाए. सविता जी हमारे पास सिर्फ एक मिनट का समय रह गया है, मैं आपसे गुजारिश करूंगा कि आप अपना सेशन कंक्लूड करें.
जी बिल्कुल. सो इसी तरह का एक और क्वेश्चन यहाँ पर है विच आई वॉन्ट आर व्यूअर्स टू डू देमसेल्फ्स. इट इज फाइंड ऑल द जीरोज ऑफ द गिवन पॉलिनोमियल हुज टू जीरोज आर गिवन टू अस. दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन ऑफ द सिमिलर टाइप. इट इज फॉर आर व्यूअर्स Here just I would like to discuss this particular one question. What this is? This question is case study based question.
Okay.
Which has been introduced by CBSE. Let us read this question out and you will find it very easy. On plotting various points on a graph and joining them with a free hand, a mathematical shape has been obtained. Here is a mathematical shape. And we have discussed in session 1, what is this mathematical shape obtained named as? Is this linear? No. Is this spiral? No. So this is a parabola. Whether this is straight U or reverse U or C, so such type of shape is known as a parabola. How many zeros are there? I have kept 3 to 4 options for this, but we are discussing it within a few seconds only.
Okay.
So how many zeros are there for this polynomial? All the points where this parabola meets x-axis will be known as its zeros. Therefore, there are only 2 zeros. The first zero is -1 and the second zero is 4.
-4.
So we have 4. 2 zeros, x equals to -1, x equals to 4. With the help of 2 zeros, hum polynomial bhi nikal sakte hain by calculating their product.
Right.
So perfect. This is the slide.
मुझे लग रहा है कुछ होमवर्क भी आप देना चाहेंगे जल्दी से. आप मुझे समाप्त करना है, यदि कोई होमवर्क हो क्लास 10 के बच्चों के लिए तो बता सकती हैं आप जल्दी से.
बिल्कुल, वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इट ऑल. हमने यहां पर अभी जो ये थर्ड फोर्थ पार्ट लिखा है डिस्कस कर चुके हैं. आई विश आवर व्यूअर्स टू सॉल्व दिस. सिर्फ 10 सेकंड्स का टाइम चाहूंगी. ये जो स्लाइड्स हैं ये थोड़ा सा स्टूडेंट्स तक चली जाएं.
Right.
So that they will be able to solve these questions and they can ask their query if any in the comment section to us.
Definitely. और comment section अभी disable हो जाएगा क्योंकि ये live streaming खत्म होने वाली है. आप अपने equations को solve कीजिएगा और उन्हें हमें भेजिएगा जैसा मैंने आपको email ID बताया था. हमारा email ID है dth.class10@cieet.nic.in. इस पर आप भेजिएगा, मैं ये सविता जी को ज़रूर भेजूंगा और वो देखेंगे कि आपने सही सॉल्व किया है या नहीं. कोई और भी क्वेश्चन आप अपना सॉल्व करना चाहें जो आपकी टेक्स्ट बुक में ना हो, उसके लिए भी आप स्वतंत्र हैं. सविता जी, आप हमारे साथ जुड़ी, आपने पॉलिनोमियल्स पढ़ाया. आई होप पॉलिनोमियल्स आज हमने खत्म कर लिया होगा.
यस राहुल जी, पॉलिनोमियल्स टॉपिक हैज बीन कंप्लीटेड टुडे.
ऑलराइट,
एंड आई विश द स्टूडेंट्स विल प्रैक्टिस द क्वेश्चंस व्हिच हैव बीन गिवन हियर ऑन द स्क्रीन.
डेफिनेटली प्रैक्टिस बहुत जरूरी है ताकि वो भूले कुछ भी नहीं. पार्ट 1, पार्ट 2 और पार्ट 3 को एक साथ देखिए और पॉलिनोमियल्स की प्रैक्टिस कीजिए. थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग अस सविता जी. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू.
मैथमेटिक्स का हमारा ये सेशन यही समाप्त होता है. अगला सेशन हमारा सोशल साइंस का है. अभी लेकर हाजिर होंगे, कहीं मत जाइएगा. देखते रहिए पीएमई विद्या चैनल्स. नमस्कार.